2006, the U.S. has absorbed 14 million immigrants because a lot of it through chain migration. Steve Camerata is director of the research for Center of Immigration Studies. Raul Reyes is an attorney and columnist. And Steve, let's start with you. Do those numbers bother you?
Well, I think the big question is this whole system essentially runs on autopilot. That is, we just keeping taking folks. People sponsor, we hand out visas through the lottery, employers want someone, they bring them in, but nobody steps back and says, look, does this 1.8 million make sense? What is the absorption capacity for our schools or for our hospitals, our roads, our physical infrastructure? How many people can we assimilate? These are all really important questions, and in general, no one's asking them.
Right. And I'll tell you, Raul, you have Australia, New Zealand, and Canada, all with one thing in common. They have a merit-based immigration, merit-based immigration system. In 1965,
right,
we changed ours. Don't you think we should reevaluate what we're doing?
Well, in 1965, one of the reasons that we changed ours under the Immigration and Nationality Act was because the old system tended to give preference to people from Western Europe and Northern Europe. So back, the Congress back then decided they wanted a more egalitarian approach. They changed the system to what we have now, and what some people refer to as chain migration, which actually the American Immigration Lawyers Association considers a pejorative term, is also known as the family unity principle. And the family unity principle really has been a bedrock of our immigration system since 1965. I know a lot of people, I don't dispute these numbers. I think maybe the difference I have with Mr. Camerati is our interpretation of them. I look at these numbers and I say, well, we are admitting a large numbers of people through legal channels,
right,
and some people are coming, obviously, undocumented. But meanwhile, we have a 4.1 unemployment rate at 17-year low. This is a historic low under this administration. So that shows, to me, in my view,
right,
that our economy does have the capacity to integrate these workers.